So, just to follow up on the rest of the front row, who decided after 6 or 8 weeks?
You said that. Hopefully the back row hears.
Who is the person in the West Wing who decided after 6 or 8 weeks that this baby formula shortage was finally something that somebody should tell the president about?
Look, again, I have to go back and talk to the president. I did not hear him take questions or answer any questions to all of you. And so this is, I want to do my due diligence, right, as his spokesperson to make sure that I have a conversation. What I can tell you is what we have been doing as an administration since the day one of a recall. And just let me just say this, because I want to make sure, since, you know, we have folks watching, that the actions that we're taking, that we took, actually made a difference here. DPA is allowing manufacturers to reliably plan for scaling production. In the case of Abbott and their suppliers, an increase of 25%, they can be manufacturing at 100% capacity. Likewise, Rickett plans to expand production by 40%. Operation Fly Formula has cut 3 to 4 week timelines for Nestle product to move Europe to 72-hour periods. Through FDA's enforcement discretion, we will get 27.5 million bottles from Bubs Australia. So these are all important actions, including the graphs that I just showed, how high production is higher than it was a year ago. So this is also important. We want to make sure that the American people, the American families know that we have been working on this 24/7. The president has done everything that he is able to do or has been able to do, and we'll continue to do more work because we understand there's more work to be done.
Okay, another big topic. When are you guys going to admit that you were wrong about inflation?
No easy questions today, huh?
The Treasury Secretary says that she was wrong, so why doesn't anybody here at the White House?
Okay, so look, what the Secretary was pointing out, this is talking about yesterday when she was doing her hit with her TV hit with CNN, is that there have been shocks to the economy that have exacerbated inflationary pressures which couldn't have been foreseen 18 months ago.
Why
including
not?
I'm trying to answer your question. I was just getting to the why not. Including Russia's decision to invade Ukraine, multiple successive variants of COVID, and lockdowns in China. As she also noted during that interview, there has been historic growth and record job creation, and our goal is now to transition to steady and stable growth as inflation is brought down, as Brian Deese said yesterday to all of you when he was standing behind this podium. So the present economic plan, as we see it, is working. Just today, we learned that the manufacturing was up in May, building on the 545,000 manufacturing jobs have been created since he took office, further proof that companies are investing in America. We are on a path to stable growth, and we are addressing supply chain problems. Our plan to tackle inflation, lower costs, reduces the deficit, and respects the FDA's independence. It's the best way for us to achieve sustainable and durable economic growth. So that's how we're doing, the work that we're doing every day to make sure that we attack lower costs.
Just that I understand, the Treasury Secretary says that she was wrong, but the White House was not wrong about inflation.
Here's the thing: we have achieved a. First of all, I explained to you what she was trying to say. So I just laid that out. So those are your words, not my words. I just laid out what she was trying to say and tried to explain in fullness. Her part in her answer. We have achieved an historic recovery through an extraordinarily unprecedented economic moment. The president has consistently noted that the primary drivers of inflation are the pandemic and Putin's invasion of Ukraine. The twists and turns of both these monumental events have affected energy prices and also food prices that we have seen these past several months. This is Putin's price hike, which the president refers to, and that is what Secretary Yellen was referring to if you read the entire transcript, and that's what I'm trying to say to you. Hopefully that lands. Go ahead.
Thanks, Karine. You say Legislative Affairs has had more than a dozen calls with lawmakers on guns recently.